direct from Studio A of the Howell Cheney Technical High School Media Production Shop. It's HCTV News.
Welcome to a new episode of HCTV News. I'm Camfield Heinrich.
And I'm Elena Lee Rivera. In this episode, we have some great stories for you, including a look at the pep rally and the many competitions that occurred, why we wear uniforms at Cheney, and a special panel discussion edition of Winter Sports Update.
That's right. First up is our take on the pep rally. There were many interesting competitions during the rally on December 22nd, including hula hoop, makeup, and tug-of-war contests.
Let's take a look.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Cheney Tech Pep Rally. My name is Matt Motika. We are about to get started here. It is an annual competition between the classes, seniors versus sophomores versus juniors versus freshmen.
Okay, so we're going to get the pep rally started. Pep rally 2017.
Well, now we're going to be moving into the three-point contest, which was started back in 1967. That's when the first three-pointer was ever made.
We hope everyone had a great time at the pep rally.
Every year, digital media students take part in the Teen Safe Driving Contest put on by the Connecticut DMV. Here's a sneak preview of our entries. Sophomores Zeke Reese, Ruby Jackson, and Gabe Rivera collaborated with students in the Prince Tech Audio Production Shop on a very creative spot. Let's check it out.
Wear a seatbelt when you're driving. If you wanna keep it riding, keep it up to the funk and the happy and popping up about the trunk of the caddy. Ha 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 ha. Wear a seatbelt when you're driving. If you wanna keep it riding, keep it up, keep your limited check before you get a ticket. Your pockets feeling the stress. See the streets as you hit on the gases. Pump it up as you zipping through traffic. They fake, but they getting fried. It's a catfish. You spun enough to the whips and the crashes. The kids should have seen the preview. A lesson from a loss evolve into an equal. The repercussions from a crash could be lethal. Here's a tip from your main man, Ezekiel. Wear a seatbelt when you're driving.
Wow, that song is going to be stuck in my head for hours. Next up, we get an inside look at uniforms from junior Chris Baton. You know, I personally don't like uniforms.
I agree. Let's see what other students said.
Here at Cheney Tech, uniforms are a part of our everyday life. Whether we're in academics or shop, we just can't seem to get away from them. So why do we wear school uniforms? I spoke with Assistant Principal Ms. Jackson to help shed light on our school uniforms.
School uniforms are a way for students to show that they're prepared for school, prepared for the work environment, and also to show school pride.
The Cheney Tech administration feels uniforms are a positive thing for the school. Some students, on the other hand, are not so fond of the school's uniforms.
I don't like uniforms.
Why?
Because it's pointless.
It's horrible.
Why?
Because I like wearing my own clothes.
Other students believe uniforms are a positive part of the Cheney culture.
They're fine, I guess.
You like them?
They don't bother me.
Personally, I like school uniforms because that way when I'm late or anything, all I have to do is grab a shirt and a pair of pants and go out the door.
How about you?
I like school uniforms because it makes the school like really organized and you can't judge people for what they wear.
Ms. Jackson also agrees that it adds to the school's culture.
By showing school pride, by showing that you're here and that you're ready to learn on a daily basis, it adds to the culture, the climate of the school in a very positive way.
For HCTV News, I'm Christopher Baton.
I hope there won't be any more uniform sweeps. Canfield, get off your phone.
I was just texting my friend. Another kind of texting which isn't so good is sexting. Junior Cole Coonan tells us all about the dangers of sexting.
Let's see what he has to say.
On September 27, 2017, the students at Cheney Tech had an assembly about the dangers of teen sexting from School Resource Officer Trooper McGrann. Trooper Brian McGrann came prepared with many statistics and facts about the topic. Many students thought his presentation was very informative.
I actually learned a lot. I learned that a good amount of teens actually are involved in sexting.
Well, some of the statistics about teen sexting are that about 25% of all high school age students are doing it. They've either sent or have an image sent to them.
According to scientific studies, teens who sext have an increase in depression, anxiety, social problems, and among many other things.
They don't understand that when you hit send, there's no having any control over where that video or picture is going to go. It can go on the internet and it can ultimately go viral. It could be seen by your potential employers. It could be seen by your parents.
Teen sexting is on the rise and punishments are getting more severe every day.
Imagine walking down the hallway or going into the cafeteria or going on the bus and just hearing everybody around you start to giggle. The humiliation factor could be so severe that there have been cases, many cases, in fact, where the pressure has gotten so bad that unfortunately it's led to suicides.
I don't think people knew about the consequences that could happen for people who do that, and they didn't know how dangerous it was, so I thought it was very effective.
An article in the Hartford Current said that in Southington, Connecticut, 14 middle school students were referred to a juvenile review board following their involvement in the sharing of nude photos and inappropriate messages sent through social media.
I feel like teens in general could stop sexting by talking about it amongst each other, saying, you know, how it's not right.
Don't sext. For HCTV News, I'm Cole Coonan.
Sexting is just unacceptable.
It definitely is. For the last couple years, we here at Cheney have held a coin drive in order to raise money for each class here at Cheney Tech. Junior Daniel Marks has a story.
Class of 2020 is holding a coin drive during the month of January. Half of the money collected will go to the class of 2020, and the other half will go to the local charity.
I think we're going to do is look at like three or four different Manchester-based charities, and we're going to let the winning team choose from those four.
Even though it looks like everything is going well, there is a problem.
A better way to do it is for each class to raise money, and that the money that they raise goes toward their class. So whatever, however much the senior class raises, that money goes into their account, and that might be more motivating.
So contribute to the coin drive, make sure to stop by and help out. Class of 2020 will appreciate it. I'm Danielle for HCTV News.
Which class will win? Stay tuned.
This week's installment of Way Back When is all about groundbreaking TV shows. Here's Emily Hansen with Way Back When.
Welcome back to Way Back When. I'm Emily Hansen. Today I'll be talking about some iconic TV shows that aired between 1948 and 2015. You've probably heard of many of these shows, but your parents or grandparents probably remember watching them live. Steve Allen was the first network talk show host. His show was called The Steve Allen Show and was on air from 1956 to 1964. He was also the first host of The Tonight Show, which he hosted from 1954 to 1957. The greatest Tonight Show host was Johnny Carson. He had an amazing 30-year career hosting. He hosted The Tonight Show from 1962 to 1992. Off-screen, he battled with emphysema, which is a disease that makes your lungs deconstruct caused by cigarette smoking. Carson passed away in 2005 at age 79 from emphysema. Here's Johnny.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here's Johnny.
So we came up with some phrase. We guarantee these will just never come up in casual conversation. Example, here's the first one. That's Mr. Rogers to you, and stay the hell out of my neighborhood.
Johnny Carson was a very famous and popular talk show host. Another great host was David Letterman. He is 70 years old this year. He first hosted The David Letterman Show, which aired for only 5 months in 1980. It was a daytime show filmed in New York. After losing a competition with Jay Leno to succeed Johnny Carson, Letterman was hired by CBS to start a competing show, which was named The Late Show with David Letterman. It aired from 1993 to 2015. Letterman was a pretty fun host. He did quirky bits and went on the street to interact with all kinds of people. Here's Letterman.
Is it always cocktail time?
Yes, always cocktail time.
Okay, and let's see, may we suggest?
A decanter of Manhattans, martinis, and daiquiris.
Now, do you have anything bigger, like a galvanized tub?
No, we don't.
What happens if you come in and you say you have a wish for fish?
A what?
A wish for fish. Is it possible, Betty, to get a decanter of fish?
Decanter of fish?
Okay, one more question. What time is it?
Cocktail time.
All right, Betty, nice meeting you.
Jay Leno, who beat Carson for the host slot, is 67 years old. He hosted The Tonight Show from 1992 to 2014. He also hosted The Jay Leno Show from 2009 to 2010. He currently has a show called Jay Leno's Garage, on since 2015. A variety show host that made a huge impact is Ed Sullivan. The Ed Sullivan Show aired from 1948 to 1971. That's 23 years and 1,068 episodes. Sullivan was born and raised in Harlem, New York. He started his career working for a New York newspaper writing the sports column. Then in 1941, he was the host of a radio show called Summer Silver Theater. On February 9th, 1964, a record-setting 73 million people tuned in to see the Beatles on the Ed Sullivan Show. And please, say to me. You let me hold your hand. You let me hold your hand. I wanna hold your hand. A lot of other very famous groups and people have performed on the Ed Sullivan Show. He was often called the star maker. If you performed on the Ed Sullivan Show, you were instantly way more famous. He showcased people like The Doors, Elvis Presley, The Rolling Stones, Jackson 5, and many more. He didn't just have music artists on his show, he also had comedians, athletes, and ventriloquists.
Will you do me a favor, Pedro?
No.
Yes. Are you tired?
No.
Not very tired, eh?
No.
Good. Rest for a while.
Sullivan didn't only change the lives of stars, he also entertained the people watching at home every Sunday night at 8 o'clock. Everyone loved him. Sullivan was a favorite of impressionists for his stiff manner and way of moving.
Now The Doors, here they are with their newest hit record, People Are Strange.
Little known fact, Sullivan suffered from arthritis affecting his spine and many of his joints. This accounted for some of his stiff manner. Being a longtime smoker, he died from throat cancer in 1974. Everyone has heard of great sitcoms like Happy Days, Bewitched, Frasier, Gilligan's Island, Full House, I Dream of Jeannie, The Wonder Years, The Brady Bunch, and I Love Lucy. I Love Lucy was on TV from 1951 to 1957. It was the most popular sitcom of its time. There are 181 episodes.
Yes, with Vitamita Benjamin, you can spoon your way to health. All you do is take a tablespoonful after every meal.
Now you take some.
Oh. It's so tasty, too. It's just like candy.
People really enjoyed watching I Love Lucy because she led a funny and quirky fictional life. I Love Lucy is still something people talk about today. A TV show that just about everyone watched in the 70s was MASH, which ran from 1972 to 1983. MASH is about members of the 4077th Mobile Army Surgical Hospital who treat wounded soldiers during the Korean War. They used humor to get away from the depressing situations around them. There are a total of 258 episodes of MASH, so it was very successful. The show takes place during the Korean War, but at the time we were at war in Vietnam. Here's MASH.
Are we gonna stand for this? We're gonna let them do this to us? No, I say, no! We're not gonna eat this dreck anymore! We want something else! We want something else! We want something else! We want something else! Grab these in the world, arise! You have nothing to lose but your cookies! We want something else!
Million people viewed the final episode of MASH all at the same time. They play reruns of MASH a lot, but it has been 34 years since they first aired the last episode. Another really popular sitcom, maybe the most popular, was Seinfeld. With 180 episodes, Seinfeld ran from 1989 to 1998. This huge success was all about four quirky friends living in New York. Jerry Seinfeld was the star and also one of the head writers for the show, along with the comedian Larry David. Everyone in Seinfeld has since starred in movies and other TV shows. I think people really enjoy Seinfeld because the characters could have similar life problems or similar experience that you have. Let's take a look at Seinfeld.
The factory in New Jersey is already making them.
They're making these?
Yes, yes. This pirate trend that she's come up with, Jerry, this is gonna be the new look for the 90s. You're gonna be the first pirate.
But I don't wanna be a pirate.
Another show about friends living in New York is Friends. This is my all-time favorite show.
So you should really be familiar with. It's what the Japanese call unagi.
Isn't that a kind of sushi?
No, it's a concept.
Yeah, it is, it is. It's freshwater eel.
All right, maybe it means that too.
Oh, I would kill for a salmon skin roll right now.
You know, fine, get attacked. I don't even care.
Ross, we're sorry. Please tell us what it is.
I think when Friends was on the air, the target audience could really relate to the characters in the show. Friends aired from 1994 to 2004 with 236 episodes and 10 seasons. There are six main characters: Monica, Ross, Chandler, Phoebe, Rachel, and Joey. Spoiler: Monica is Ross's little sister. Chandler is Ross's best friend from college. Chandler is also Monica's husband. Ross is known as the divorce guy, who had been divorced from Rachel and later on has a baby with her. Joey is a soap opera star, and Phoebe's a masseuse. Everyone in this show has a lot of relationship issues, but in the end, everyone's happy together. Do you remember watching these shows? Which show was your favorite? Next episode, I'll be talking about the most famous music artists throughout the generations. For HCTV News, I'm Emily Hansen.
Elena, I already told you I'm not going to wear the puffy shirt, even though the low talker wants me to. I don't want to be a pirate!
Recently, seniors Matt Motika and Ijabel Clinton discussed the boys and girls basketball season with two senior players in this episode of Sports Update. Let's bounce right into it.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to an inside look into the girls and boys basketball season. My name is Matt Motika, and I'm joined by Ijabel Clinton. We are also joined by senior captain Jake Montas and senior captain Madison Tufi. So, Jake, with the beginning of the season, what has given the boys' team so much success as far to have a good record?
Senior leadership, wanting to do better than last year. Our record was 3-17 last year, which wasn't too good. So, and a new coach, he's given us a good boost this year too.
What is the record so far?
2-0.
How about you, Madison? What is your record right now?
3-0.
And what has gotten you there so far?
Communication and just playing as an all-around team.
Okay. Now, Jake, you touched upon on new coaches. How much of an impact has he made so far? Not just from the coaching aspect, but as a former player here. What has he been able to give you guys?
He's told us to, as a senior, to really enjoy the time you have left because the game's gonna go by quick. And being a former player, he gives us a better look on things. We go over film and he just knows everything about what we do.
So he's like giving you guys more of an inside look than what you guys previously had?
Yeah.
That's good.
Madison, is there any new coaches on the girls' basketball team?
Yes, Adam Starvish.
Is there anything different that he does compared to the last coach?
I mean, besides his coaching techniques, we do a lot more plays, we do a lot more running, and and we just get ourselves in shape more than last year.
What have some of the new styles been like, Maddie?
Well, for one, we watch film a lot. And you know, we look at what we did, what we didn't do. And last year we didn't really have that, so this year it's kind of good to look at that.
What kind of impact have the seniors made for your teams?
Seniors have been pretty big on our team for the fact that we have 8 right now, and we have 1 injured on the way back, though. So we'll have 9.
Big class. Have they been there for all 4 years, all 9 of them?
Most of them, we've played for like 4 years with each other, so the chemistry is pretty good.
That's good.
Any senior impacts on the girls' basketball team?
I mean, there's only 4, but when seniors leave, it'll leave a good impact on the freshmen, leave them with good leadership skills, and also with the juniors that will be incoming seniors.
Nice.
Since you guys are only 2 and 3 games in respectively, what does the rest of the season look like? Because you guys got 17 games left and you guys got 18. What are you looking for the rest of the season?
Looking for at least 8 wins and making it into the conference tournament.
Is the conference competitive?
Yeah, it is competitive.
How do you think you guys stack up this year?
I think we could make it.
Is there any teams that you play in the future that you think will be hard and competitive against the team?
Well, the one team that I really know that's going to be competitive is the Holiday Tournament, which is against EC Goodwin. Mm-hmm. And that would be a very hard game, only because of the way they play, and we would just have to step up our game.
Have you both played for 4 years?
No.
I've played for 3.
So, with the most recent realigning of the conferences, has that made a big impact on you guys, or is it too soon to really notice?
Well, Capital Prep not being in the conference, they're pretty much a powerhouse team, so.
That's good. Get rid of the big boys.
And then University probably could have beat them. Didn't really make a difference by them leaving. So.
What about you, Maddie? What about the conference is changing for you guys?
I mean, there's competition, but, you know, as Jake said, with Capital Prep not being there and university, it kind of puts us in a good position.
That's good. Well, I know from Egypt and I, we both wish you guys the best of luck in your remaining games, and we hope to see you guys in the playoffs and hopefully bring home a championship.
We hope you enjoyed this episode of HCTV News. Remember to like and subscribe for all our content from the Digital Media Shop. For HCTV News, I'm Canfield Heinrich.
And I'm Elena Rivera.
See you next time.